right. I'm ready excited. To do some homework?
I am ready for homework. Okay. Let's do it.
You got the first question.
All right. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Who's this?
Mikala.
Hi, Mikala.
Hello, Mikala.
What grade are you in, Mikala?
I'm in eighth.
Eighth grade. Okay. So I'm going to go to the board and I'm going to help you out with your problem, okay?
Okay.
Okay, great. Mikala, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Monroe, New York.
Monroe, New York. All right, Mikala, I am ready to do some eighth grade problems.
Okay. Do I say it now?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Okay, it's the problem negative 2x plus 23 equals 1 plus 9x.
Okay. So negative 2x plus 23 equals 1 plus 9x. I bet there were some directions. What do they want you to do with that?
Huh?
What are you supposed to do with this problem?
Solve each equation algebraically. Show each step and then circle the solution.
Okay, great. So we're going to take a look at this problem. We want to solve it, and we're going to solve for x. That's what it means in algebra. So which means we want to get the x all by itself when we're done. That means there's one number that if we came up with would make this true, would balance out the side. There's some number, if you multiply it by negative 2 and add 23 to it, will get you the same answer as if you multiplied that number by 9 and you added 1 to it. So the idea is that we want to keep these things balanced. All right, Mikala, where do you think you want to start with this problem?
Do we subtract 2 from the 9?
Okay, so you want to kind of combine like terms. We want to group our like terms. So I've got a minus 2x on this side, and I've got a 9x on this side. And when we're done, we really only want to have 1x. So let's kind of get our x's to the same side, right? And the way that you're going to do that is you're going to do the inverse. So the inverse of negative 2x, which means kind of like subtracting 2x, is to...
Add
2x, right. So we're not just going to add the 2, we're going to add the whole term. We're going to keep the x with the 2, okay? So we're going to add 2x to this side, and whatever you do to the left side of the equation, we are going to do to the right side of the equation. Awesome. All right, what happens when I have a negative 2x and a positive 2x?
You have a negative number.
Well, a negative 2x and a positive 2x, when we combine them, what will happen? If you take away 2 and then you put 2 back, what number would you end up on?
You would add up with 11?
Nope. So you're just talking about this side. I was just talking about the left side still. So the negative 2x plus the 2x, those guys are going to cancel each other out, okay?
Yeah, yeah. Great. But you were talking about the 9 plus the 2x.
Right. So you already got that. So what's the 9 plus 2x?
11.
11x. Great job. Okay, so we're going to bring everything down. We got 23 is equal to 1 plus 11x. Nice job. All right, what are we going to do next?
You're going to subtract 23 from both sides.
You're going to take away 23 from both sides. And why do you want to take away 23 from both sides?
Because it doesn't have a variable.
Okay, so let's think about this. We know the problem is done in the end when we have the x on one side by itself and a number on the other side, right? So that's how you know a problem is done. That's the whole goal of algebra, is to have x equals a number. So on this side, I've got a number kind of by itself. But my problem is I'm just trying to get x alone. I'm trying to isolate the variable. That'll be the term that you hear, which just really means we're trying to get the x alone. So when I look over here, I see this 11x and I've got the plus 1. I see that the 1 is kind of hanging on to the x, and the 11 times the x is hanging on to the x. So what we're going to do is we're going to get rid of the 1 from the right side so that the x is getting closer to being all by itself. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So we want to get rid of this 1. So how do you get rid of a 1?
We
subtract 1. So we're going to subtract 1 from the right side, but if we do it to the right side, we got to do it to the left side, right?
Uh-huh.
Awesome. So now what we have is 23 take away 1 is...
22.
Great. And then we're going to bring down the 11x, and we still have 11x. Okay? So we're getting a lot closer. Way up here, we had a whole bunch of, we had a big mess of a problem. And now when we come down here, we're getting a lot closer just having the x all by itself. Okay. So we've got 22 equals 11x. The only thing that's bothering that x is that 11 times it. So what would be the inverse of multiplying by 11?
Divide by 11.
Dividing, right. You just do the opposite. I've got a teenager who does that frequently, does the opposite of whatever I tell her to do. So this problem is just like doing that. So if we're going to divide this side by 11, what are we going to do to the other side?
Divided by 11.
Divided by 11. Great. Okay. So when we have 11 and we divide it by 11, 11 divided by 11 is?
0. It cancels
itself. Not 0. 11 divided by 11 is the number 1. And remember, I told you we'd be done with this problem. We got down to 1x. So that's what we got. We have 1x. But you don't have to put the 1 in front of the x. We can just write the... We can just do the 11 divided by 11 is the number 1. And what is 22 divided by 11?
2.
2. Great. So then it says to clearly mark your answer, right? I think it said circle your answer.
Yeah.
Or mark it. I like to put a little cloud around mine. So my answer is 2 equals x or x equals 2. Either way is the right answer. Okay? Okay. Thanks, Mikala. That was a fun problem.